Hello everyone, I'm CrypticFox, and welcome back to my illustrious floating mansion here in this wonderful sea that I'm stuck in here. Now, there's been a new update that's come up for Raft, so I thought I would jump in and play a little bit. It did come out roughly, I want to say about a week ago, but I unfortunately was traveling, so I didn't get a chance to play it, and I didn't see the update come out. But since the last episode, I haven't had a chance to really come in and play this. I've kind of been tied up, focused on the new alpha gameplay that I've been able to get into for World's Adrift. There's that shark, which... does he look different? I'm not sure if he does. There's a new update that came out that added some new things to the game. They added a day and night cycle, which is really cool. As you can see, they've updated the thatch, so now it looks like these giant palm leaves instead. They've put in a new type of food that you can eat called the beetroot. There's a nail that you can make, which gives you another purpose to use for your scrap. And they fixed a variety of little bugs and stuff. I'm getting a funny little bug here where I'm getting fatigue, actually, the way you normally would when you're in the water, even though I'm not in the water. So it's almost like the way the waves are moving, I'm dipping down just enough that I'm getting the fatigue. So it doesn't seem to be really causing an issue, but that is something that you'll see kind of popping up on the screen there. This is version 1.05. I actually thought that it would just do an automatic update when there was new things that were available, but it doesn't seem to do that. You actually have to download a completely new version of the game in order to get those updates. So I'm trying to find the... and here's the chest here. I want to make another chest simply because this one chest that I had down here, I've already filled it up. And it looks like... let's see. So apparently you can hold R now and move the mouse. So you can do smooth rotation. So you can choose... oh, cool. So you can actually pick an angle on things now. So you can either just hit R and have it swap around, or you can do like a little smooth rotation, which is kind of cool. I'm hoping that that will work with walls also, because that might actually give us the ability to place diagonal walls. It may not. I want to test it out. Oh, get out of here, shark. I can't tell if this shark looks different or not. I thought I saw something saying that there was a new shark version in here, but I don't know. So I'm going to try when I do a little bit of building to see whether we can place some different angled walls. At the end of the last episode, I did actually figure out, too, after I'd already stopped recording, how to harvest from these palm trees that I'm growing. So I'm going to have to definitely grow some more of these, because we can get wood, thatch, and coconuts out of these. And the coconuts give you water. I didn't notice whether they gave me any food value, but they definitely gave me some water value. They've also updated the way that the little water purifiers look. So now you've got your can kind of hangs around on the side instead of kind of being in the middle of it. Let's see, we use that up. Get this filled with water. Still the same process for filling these constantly, though, unfortunately. So it still sucks up a fair amount of time keeping up with that. Mind you, if I can get to a point where I can get some more coconut trees growing here, they do provide pretty good water value, so I think that might work out good. I'm going to take some of these seeds and we'll just stick them in here for now, because I need the room in my inventory, but I don't want to get rid of these altogether, because we definitely want to grow more coconuts. Got lots of wood and stuff in here. Plenty of potatoes. I've already planted a bunch of those. I did notice that when you harvest the potatoes, you get roughly two for every one that you planted. So in here, if we check out, if we harvest these, so that gave me six raw potatoes. Is that it? Yeah. So three. I had three in there, and I had ended up with six. So kind of you get a bonus three basically. So I guess if you kind of munch on these quickly enough, I guess you can kind of do something with that. I'm going to throw one of these on the grill. Actually, I should throw this shark meat on the grill. I don't know if the shark meat goes bad if you don't cook it in time. I have a good chunk of fish and shark here. I should maybe create a crate that's specifically just for food products, since I seem to be getting quite a bit of that. I mean, between, you know, the potatoes and what have you. I think the sun actually changed, so now we've got a different angle on the shadow, which is cool. So the shadow effects are neat. You can see it kind of marching across the deck. It's kind of a cool new addition. I'm going to collect... I have so much stuff here to collect. These little nut things gather just crazy amounts of materials. Oop. Oh, alright, I'm full of stuff. I'm just dumping things on the ground now. What have I got in here that I can get rid of? Not a ton. I guess I got rid of the potatoes. Want them in there. Apologies, my voice is a little bit off. I've actually had a rough weekend of strep throat this weekend, so I'm just kind of getting over that enough that I can actually speak properly again. I uploaded a video earlier. It's an empty net. It says it's empty, but there's definitely something there. There we go. uploaded a video earlier today, World Adrift, but I actually recorded it last week and didn't get a chance to upload it because I was away traveling. And then now I just got back and I got strep throat on the weekend. It's been a wonderful week all around. All right, so here's one of the new things you can build. So we can build a standing lantern. We can build a table and we can build a chair. So I guess you can make like your own little house now with some furniture in it. I'm going to build a lantern just because now that there's a day-night cycle. I guess I thought it was. I guess I need to make a tin can here first. Now there's a day-night cycle, we'll actually need to have some light, I guess. Otherwise, we'll find ourselves sitting in the dark. All right, where's that lantern? Gosh, I'm... Oh, you gotta place it right away, too. Okay, this is a standing lantern. I'll set it over here, I guess. That seems to be mostly out of the way. It gives a pretty decent amount of light, too. That's pretty good. I'm gonna grab this, and we'll eat that. Let's grab the water, and we'll have a drink. The never-ending cycle of food and water consumption continues. Alright, so I don't have a lot of room in my inventory right now, so I'm not going to chop down the palm trees, even though the coconuts do give really good liquid supply. I wish there was a better way to protect my raft from sharks. And will this thing burn all the time? It doesn't seem to be any way to interact with the torch once you put it down, so I guess it just stays going all the time, and then during the daytime it doesn't really matter so much because it's kind of bright. Maybe I shouldn't have put these trunks there. See if I can shift those around later. On the second level up here, I should put another torch, I think. So I'm going to need, again, another tin can. And then we can build our little torch. This one I'm going to put inside the building. So we have some light in there, which is cool. And then maybe we can put a table and chairs in here, too, just for the... Just for the sake of having decorations. Oh, there's a nails that we can make in here now, too. So I guess I should make some of those. And then I guess I need nails for the table. Oh, and interestingly, it doesn't need rope. It's actually just using the thatch, I guess, because it's like the seat or whatever. All right, we have a table and chairs now. It sounds like the shark is chomping on my raft here somewhere. Oh, he did take a piece. That rotten shark. Just replace that right away. Oh, we got this one over here, too. Man, I gotta keep on top of this. I think the shark is actually biting a little more frequently now. Alright, table and chairs. I'm gonna put those in here. They're really just a decoration, I think. I don't know that there's any real purpose that they serve. Nope, I don't wanna do that. Alright, let's put this down here, and we'll put the chair down here. Switch to 5. You know what? Let's put the table down first because I don't know how much space it takes up. Oh, that's a big table. Jeez. I'm a lone guy on a raft and I have my very own harvest table. Alright, we'll put that right here by the window, I guess. And then the chair, I might as well just put right here at the end. Just give it a little spin. There we go. Can I sit in them? No, I can't sit in it. I guess it's just there for decoration. Still, you know, it's like a palace, right? Table and chairs. It's the height of luxury when you're floating around on a raft. All right, I'm going to gather up some more supplies because I think I did use up a fair amount of stuff there. Interestingly, I think the item that I used up the most of there was the scrap, which is good because I actually had tons of it in my chest that I had no use for. Let's make some more nails just to use up some of this scrap here. I guess you get 2 nails every time you use it, so that's all right. No, I can't grab that. Oh, what did I just drop? I picked something up, but I don't know what I dropped. Oh, no, I'm dying of thirst again. The struggle is real. Okay, what can I get rid of? Put some wood planks in here. Because I'm going to need room to grab both of these waters here. That. Oh, it stacks now. Oh, that's amazing. Alright, good. Okay, so it didn't stack before. So now that it stacks, that makes that much easier. Oh, there we go. Perfect. Alright, so that's much more simple. The night cycle's not too long either. Actually, we cruised that through that pretty quickly. I want to make, like, a really big raft where we can do, like, a whole little, I don't know, like a little town or something. I was kind of thinking originally, like, if I could make something that looks sort of like a pirate ship and then do, like, a dock with a building next to it. But the way that the walls are set up in this game, I don't think I can really do that. I haven't gotten any of the beetroots yet. I wonder how I get those. I'm assuming they would just come in the barrels, but I haven't gotten any in the barrels that I grabbed so far. Let's try doing a little experiment here. I'm going to build another level up here on top of my house. And then I can try experimenting a little bit with the walls and see if we can place those on an angle now. I think that would be interesting. And there should actually be a way here that I can... If I build the floor out here... Why can't I build... Oh, I can't build there. I need to make a pylon down below, I guess. Let's see. Put a pillar down here, and then I can build out... All right, so I can do one right there, I think. We'll cover it. And we'll need... That's not foundation I want. Floor, there we go. If I build the floor here, then I can put another pillar over here. Listen, I don't know how pretty this is going to look. That will let me put another floor up here. I don't know if this is going to work out the way I want. So what I was thinking is I put another floor here. And then I think I can chop this away now. I don't know. We can put stairs here, though, I think. So now that I've got that up, yeah. So now that I got that up there, I can put stairs there. Now I'm out of water again. Ah. Let's go grab some more to drink. I want to get off of this. Let's go up to 6. Grab that. Drink. Fill. Put it back. Grab that. Drink. Fill. Put it back. It's over and over again. Alright. I think it was the last of the raw shark meat I have there, too. We'll get that on the grill, though, because we're going to need food again. The shark does give you quite a bit of food for each chunk of meat that you eat. However, it doesn't last forever. Alright, so we got another row up here that we can go. Now, what's going to be tricky is, I don't think, unless I stack up more pillars, I don't think I can put a floor at the end. Oh, here comes the shark. Oh, I thought it was all the way down the bottom. It wasn't yet. Come on, get out of here, you. I think they added a new sound effect for when you're poking a shark. Oh, geez, it took more than 3 pokes to get him off, too. All right, before it was three jabs every time got him off the raft, but that's clearly not the case anymore. Let's maybe repair this a little bit. How do we go to repair mode again? There we go, repair. Oh, that's funny. It wasn't even the piece that he was showing his biting on, I don't think. It got damaged. All right, the rest of this is okay. Let's grab this barrel in here. Come here. The barrel. All right, I kind of wanted to keep building this upwards, but I really don't think I'm going to be able to. I didn't really plan this out super well. I should have maybe done my pillar placement a little bit differently. I mean, I suppose instead of having... I could have put the ramp over here, I guess. I don't know. If I can find some of those beets, I'd like to plant those too, but... Nope. Oh, I don't know what I just threw in the water there, but... Oh, I did get a beet. All right, that's good. I'm going to build another planter over here. Let's see. Planters are... Right there. And I think I threw it on the floor. Awesome. How is it that I'm like so flush with materials now? I don't get that. There we go. Now we can play. Can I pick it up? Let me pick it up. I can't pick it up. Pick it up. Crop plot. There we go. Whew. Put that down here for the beat. Stick a crop plot right here. And then if we go up, we can go to the beet. Plant the seed. Nice. All right, back for food and water this time. Shark. Munch, munch, munch. Drink that. Refill that. Stick it back on there. I don't really like where I have this placed anymore. This is actually getting really inconvenient. Now, you can't actually move these, apparently. If you chop them with the axe, and then it'll let you kind of place them somewhere else. And I probably should do that, because it's getting to be kind of inconveniently placed. Relative to what I'm trying to do. It might even be easier if I just took away one of the flooring pieces somewhere and had, like, a little kitchen with a hole in the middle. Let's build some walls. I want to try and test out this theory of how we can place these things. Let's see. In our structures here, what have we got? Oh, you know what? It's actually with the hammer, so we may not be able to do rotation when we place them. Let's see here. So we got a wall. No, you can't smooth rotate the walls. You can only smooth rotate objects. That's kind of a shame. It would have been cool to be able to do something like that. Kind of put the walls on an angle. However, that does not appear to be an option, and it doesn't look like I'm really going to be able to build up here either. I totally duffed this whole setup. I'm going to need to change that around, because I can't build up any farther this way. All right, let's drop down. I'm going to drop down one of these palm trees here, so we can grab some of the coconuts, and we'll get some coconut milk. That'll help a lot with the thirst, I think. Oh, come back here. Whew, coconut tried to roll away. I hadn't seen them do that before. When I did it before, the coconuts didn't fall out of the tree until I'd actually chopped the whole thing down. Oh, there goes more. Oh, come back here. No. Ugh, I can see it right there. Can I get it? I got it. Don't eat me, shark. Oh, it was right behind me, too. Get out of here. All right, well, we didn't see any more coconuts falling there, I don't think. Oh, I thought for sure I got some coconut seeds, but I guess not. Nevertheless, I have some in here, so this will work. Apparently, I actually have to put it on my bar so I can plant it. There we go. Put another palm tree in there, and nighttime comes again. It's kind of cool having a day-night cycle now. It gives kind of a neat, different ambiance to the game. I think I'm going to move all this stuff over to the garden area. So I've got my cooking station. It can go to over here now. Number 7. There we go. Put the cooking station there. And then I'll need to grab... I think I have to grab the water cans off of here before I chop it. Otherwise, I'll lose them. I keep hearing these crunching noises, and I'm not sure if it's that crazy shark eating my stuff or just, like, ambient sound effects. Keeps freaking me out. All right, all that's moved over. I'm going to need to place my cans back on here, I guess. So let's get this filled with water. Get that going. I should have rotated these around, actually, so the cans were on this side. I don't know if it makes a difference or not. Cook. That's interesting. It's giving me a choice to cook, but I didn't have anything. Oh, shark! Oh, get out of there. Oh, I think we killed it. Oh, we did. Yeah, we're getting shark meat. Yeah. All right, we got a good chunk of shark meat off of that. I don't know which one he damaged, though. Let's try to check here for repairs. So he kind of jumped all the way across and bit that plank instead of coming at it from the side. This is really weird. This may not have been the best idea to place my drinking water and stuff here, simply because it looks like it might actually be in range of him biting it now. I do like that it's close to the water, though, so I don't have to run to actually fill the can up. So that works out pretty good. Let's build another can, though. We're going to need that in order to fill up this other water tank. Another water purifier, whatever. Let's fill that. Stick it there. Good to go. I really wish I'd rotated that now. This here, I'm actually going to put over on this side, I think. Right there. Get some shark meat cooking on there. All right, we're all set. Well, I decided to go a slightly different route. I was trying to build up on this one little platform that I had over here to try to build my tower, but I think what I'm going to do is just leave this maybe as a two-level building, and then where I was going to build my palm forest, thing, or my little palm farm over here, I think I'm going to build this into my little multi-level building instead. So I think I've given myself enough space here now that I can actually put platforms on, or put the stairs on, rather, so we can kind of have the stairs kind of going around the building. I could do the stairs going through the middle of the building if I set the pillars up properly. The tricky part will just be that they'll, of course, take up a certain amount of space. And I'm going to want to make sure I have enough room to actually kind of do stuff. I'm not sure what else they're planning to add to the game. I have a feeling at some point they're going to add in a bed since they added in a table and chairs. So I kind of want to have space for that. I am going to need, based on the way the sun's going here, I'm going to need another torch here so we can have a little bit of nighttime light again. Where was that? There it is here. I don't have room in my inventory for it. Arg! Pick up tin can. Oh, I'm just dropping it on the... That's great. Alright, let's get rid of this scrap here. And then hopefully I can pick up this tin can. There we go. Now we can craft our torch. And we'll stick that right there. Pick up this thatch again, or scrap, whatever it is. Okay, so I think if we place... Where do I want my stairs to be? So I'd kind of like to have it so like you come across here. Oh, let's get out of the water before it become a snack for somebody. So you come across here, and I got to do the stairs either to the left or to the right maybe right away. Or maybe just have it so you... See, the trouble is I'd like to put it inside, but I know that the walls are going to be a problem. So maybe go do it right away to the left here. Let's see. So we do stairs. We rotate this. If we do immediately to the left, and then we're going to need a pillar at the end. That was foolish pillar placement, actually. I should have put it here so I could extend my reach. Let's chop this one down, get the resources back. All right, so we could do a pillar there, and that will give me plenty of reach, and then a pillar here, and that'll get me all the way to the corners, I think. In terms of interior here, I'm gonna need a pillar over here. Sounds like something's chomping on my boat, but I don't see him. I don't see any extra gaps either. the sounds keep throwing me off. All right, so I think if I do it like that, then I can do my floor here. No, stop doing that. Come on. That's a weird glitch. All right, so we do floor. I'm all out of wood. I took so much wood building this floor, and I have tons of thatch now here, too. I guess I should make some more rope to kind of clear up some of that thatch space. Okay, we have some more wood for building. I've come to a realization, though, about the food supply. So I have quite a bit that I'm growing right now. But as it turns out, the beets and the potatoes don't really seem to give you a lot of food once you eat them. So I think I might find myself in a position where I really need to fish more. The shark, when you can kill him, gives you a great stock of meat. And it seems to give you a decent amount when you eat it. But I definitely need to do some more fishing so that I can make sure that I've got enough of a food supply that I'm actually getting a decent amount of food out of it. So let's see here. I'm going to try and make another pillar here so I can get some more floor coverage. This is actually giving me pretty good reach on the floor. I can cover this whole bottom area, I think, now that I planned this out better, with a fairly minimal number of pillars. So I can have two spaces in between each. This will get me almost all the way to the edge, but not quite to the edge, just because of the size of how the whole thing works out. But using this, I can actually cover almost this entire floor, I think. No, I'm going to run out of wood. But it does give me a really good idea of what I can kind of cover here. All right, so we've covered off pretty much this whole second floor now. So I guess I have maybe a little strip over on the side here that I didn't have enough pillar support for, but that's okay. I think I'm just going to leave that the way that it is so that we have that little gap on the side that doesn't have something built on it. And then this will be where I can build my little tower kind of thing. So I'll continue working, I think, on the tower the next time I come back and play again. This little one that's over here that I have, I'll kind of leave the way that it is for now. I can maybe put some more palm trees up on the roof there just so I can have a better supply. It would be nice to be able to get some more consistency in the planks because I'm using a lot of wood to try to build this all out. I'm going to leave this whole bottom level open just because I want to be able to run around and stab at the shark. I'm really curious actually whether he'll bite a floor section that has a wall on it. I have a feeling he will, otherwise you could just wall around your whole bottom of your raft, I guess, and then not have to worry about him anymore, but... I'm kind of curious whether he will or he won't. I'd like to test it, but I'm not sure how to go about doing that. If I do put a wall up and he decides to bite it, I may not be able to jab at him because the wall will be in the way, so I don't know how that works. We'll try that maybe out next time. I'll throw up some walls and see what happens. We've got a pretty good little kitchen supply thing going over here. I could do with making maybe another one of these cook stoves. Oh, this guy's coming in close. Get out of here. This is not working. Anyway, I'm going to try and get the shark again later. This works out really well here in terms of like a little cooking space. I've got all my materials really close by, so I can kind of do a lot of really quick cooking and eating and stuff. I can even just like harvest things and then replant it and put it right on the cook thing, which is awesome. I could use maybe a second one of these stoves just so I can cook food at a little bit faster rate. This is working really good for the water, having two of them, so I think it would work probably really good to have two of the cooking stations also, but... we'll come back next time. We'll build some more on that tower over there. I'm really curious to see what they continue to add in the game in terms of updates. Hopefully they'll have some other cool things that we can kind of check out later at another time. But thanks everyone for checking out the video. I'm as always CrypticFox. I'll see all of you next time.